Hi, this is Mayhem News Live, Impact Thursday. Sorry, no music this morning. I'm having problems with my music player, so. Not really much to talk about as far as Impact Thursday. I mean, there's one big thing happened. That was about the most to talk about. Magnus took on Joe in an action-packed match. It was part of the World Heavyweight Championship tournament. Joe tries to hit Magnus, but misses and runs into a chair. Magnus rolls him up for the win. Sorry about the voice. Got a sinus infection, so my sinuses are killing me. So anyway, Gail Kim defeats Candice LeRae. Don't ask me either. She did a power bomb and then finishes with the eat defeat. Finishing move for the win. Rude defeats Storm. A little bit of tension between Storm and Gunner at the end. Ethan Carter defeats Sharkboy. That was actually a high point, seeing Sharkboy again. And the big match between Anderson and Bully Ray. If Bully Ray loses, the Aces and Eights are disbanded. Great match, back and forth. A little bit of drama, you can never knew who's gonna win. But Anderson wins and Aces and Eights are no more. And all the fans say, thank you, God. Not much to do for Thursday Impact Thursday, so I'm just gonna go ahead and go into Friday's SmackDown Fridays. We're gonna do that show as well. I'll just go ahead and add it on to this one, so since the other one was, there wasn't much to talk about, to be frankly honest. Other than Hogan's probably not coming back to TNA, which, to be frankly honest, might be good for TNA. SmackDown opens up with Goldust and Cody taking on the Real Americans. Very decent back and forth action. Both teams had a good showing. Cesaro goes for the big swing and he kind of pays for it. Cody comes off the ropes and hits the disaster kick, which sets up a curtain call from Goldust for the win. Goldust and Cody's been on a roll since they got back. I think they've only had one defeat so far. Ryback issues an open challenge, which Kali accepts. It was a pretty good match between Kali and Ryback. Kali taking advantage pretty often. But Ryback ends up getting the advantage and hits the shell shock on Kali for the win. AJ Lee, for some reason, took on the Funkadactyls, Naomi and Cameron. Tamina tries to interfere on her part, but Naomi hits the rear ending for the win. Needless to say, AJ Lee was not happy. Rey Mysterio, in his first match since back, teams up with the Usos to face the Shield. Shield pretty much ruled the match, but Rey Mysterio ended up getting a 619 for the win. So it's a good return. Big E, your new Intercontinental Champion, teams up with Ziggler to face Sandow and Axel. Axel, they pretty much beat on Ziggler, Sandow, and Axel does until he gets a hot tag to Big E, and both him and Ziggler come in. Ziggler hits the Famaster on Sandow, and Big E hits the big ending on Axel for the win. Says hello, by the way. The big finish, Brian versus Luke Harper. Harper dominates early. Looks like he's going to get the win. Punk's music hits, which kind of throws the Wyatts off. And Brian actually gets the win. They do take on the Wyatts, but end up getting kind of decimated at the end. So I guess it was the heels' turns to win. I am still in the process of reviewing, trying to catch up on Ring Warriors. I'm going to do a special show just on Ring Warriors. If I can ever get over this weather change and everything, I'm going to try to do that. Where I can catch back up, and that way only I can just add them to whenever they post a show. So, not a real big show today. Just, the SmackDown was actually pretty decent. TNA was, you know, better without Hogan. I said, stop. Seth really wants to be on TV today. But I know it's not really a long show, but there really wasn't much to record, you know, because I do all the headlines on the Tuesday show. So far, everybody's talking about 2K14, the game. I'll be honest, until they put Roddy Piper and a couple other people in there, they're not going to get any talk about it from me, because they're definitely not going to get no money from me. I'm not going to go play a game based on WrestleMania 30-year history and not get to see Roddy Piper versus Goldust in a back alley match. I'm sorry, you know. That would have been awesome, you know, to be able to drive the Cadillac and, you know, hey. But anyway, that's been the show today. Sorry, no music. I want to say something out to my sponsors. I appreciate your help. You can follow them at Zach Pack Promotions. You can check out Fight Disability Slurs. .wordpress.com. And also you can check out Throttle's music on Stop Now. My son really wants to be on TV. He wants to be on camera today, so he wants y'all to hear him so he knows y'all here. And check out Throttle stuff on Amazon and iTunes. Sorry no music. My player's kind of missing. My old phone, Seth has been playing with it, so I got to find it. Other than that, I want to shout out to Blast 52 drummer and her band Blast 52, and they're a great band. They got good music. They're also on iTunes and Amazon. I'll add the little thing at the end of it. You can see the links. And I want to send a thing out to Girls with Big Guns and also the real Louisville Ghostbusters. They're still trying to find money to get Ecto another engine. So if you want to, you can follow them on Facebook and find out where you can donate, or I think maybe you can go through Zach Pack Promotions. But I want to thank everybody. I want to thank Chance Prophet, who was our first, in my opinion, big interview. Him and Goldust were actually our first interview. I did not do a video or a audio thing with Goldust. I did a thing on our mayhem-news.com site. But I want to thank him, Gabe Layall, who has childhood cancer. He's fighting, him and his family are fighting, you know, fighting, have a fight of their life. So give your prayers and thoughts. But this has been Mayhem News Live. And hopefully next week I'll feel better. y'all have a good day.